But he looks at me, and I look at him, and he looks at me, and I look at him, and he looks at me, and I look at him.
You're coming home with me.
Hey, what's going on? So I am John Travolta here to give you some art tips, review some art supplies, and as well as teach you how to make some cool stuff along the way. So today we are going to be reviewing Target art supplies. So I was just wandering around a Target, absolutely no purpose for being there at all, just wanted to get out of the house, and then I came across an entire row of art supplies. And I was so surprised by what they had. One, two, half of the aisle was all Mondo Llama brand. So I'm assuming this is now Target's house brand because it was the cheaper option. They also had like Prismacolor color pencils. They had Tombow brush pens. They had all the calligraphy tools you could ever imagine were there. So somebody has gotten the hint that art supplies are very popular right now, and they are beefing up their stock there. So much so that, like, if I just needed, like, one or two little random things, I could probably go to Target and also get my, you know, loaf of bread and bananas as well. So that is very convenient. All right, so plan for today is that I purchase some markers, some paint markers, canvases, and a sketchbook, and we're going to review all of those today on this video. So let's get to it and let's make some art. The main thing that got me to stop was this pack of markers. So they're dual tip markers, you know, they look like the Copic markers, alcohol markers. It says that they're for shading, layering, and that they are blendable. And this whole thing, which is 40 different colors in here, was only $25. So it wasn't that expensive for like how many markers you get. So that comes with a chisel tip. And then the other side, oh, it's really fine. The other one is this little fine point tip. Let's see, can that get in focus? Can you focus for me, please? There we go. So, not as, like, brushy as I was expecting, but they did have brush tip markers as well, more on, like, the Tombow side of things, but we'll test these as well. Oh my days. And it does come with, like, a little carrier inside of this that is, like, holding them in their place, so that's super nice. Means all the colors will stay where they are supposed to. Alright, cool. So, oh, and then the last thing, I got a sketchbook as well. It says for drawing and sketching with, there's 80 pages in it. I couldn't find what like the GSM or like the weight of these pages are. It didn't say it anywhere on there. So we'll just test some of the markers, see if they bleed through, and then we'll also see if like they rip up with the paint markers and whatnot too. So got a lot of stuff to test, got a lot of stuff to draw, so let's go ahead and get into that. Let's start testing out some markers. Alright, so there is a little color test of all of these markers so far, and I don't have a lot of Copic markers. So these are the colors that I do have. So I'm gonna make a little line and then we will try to find the best comparison to that color. One thing that I'm noticing just like right off the bat, there's not like a true yellow in this lot. So like this color might be the, this one might be the closest, but it's not like yellow. And this color that like looks yellow was that color. It came out like peach, like skin tone. So, like a peach skin tone. So that's kind of interesting. And then also some of the colors are very similar. Like this one, and this one are all basically the same orange, even though it's this, and this one. So that's kind of interesting. Do I like these tones? Yes, they definitely are like the boho vibe, which is cool. Good to like add to the arsenal of markers to draw with. But let's compare them to the Copics just in terms of like pigment. Just do pink. I've had some of these markers for a very long time, so I'm sorry if they're not the best markers. Alrighty, so there are our Copic markers all along the side, and let's do a little test of the Mondo Llama markers. Alright, so like I said, first off, there's not a yellow, like I don't have a yellow really to compare this to, but I guess we can compare this to this pink for the first one. Very different. I don't even know what to use for yellow. I'm just gonna skip that one for now. Alright, this one looks to be like a true... So on the left are the Mondos, on the right are the Copics, and you can see that like there is a difference. I try to just go like what colors like look the most similar. These colors seem to have more notes of like yellows, oranges. Well, these have more notes of like blues and purples, I will say. As for saturation though, like they covered the same. It's just a different color, I think, is the biggest difference. If you were to put these on a piece of paper, I don't really know if I'd be able to tell the difference. Using the marker itself though, I could definitely tell the difference of like how it moved on a piece of paper. These are a little bit softer, while the Mondo markers are like pretty hard. And if you didn't get the right angle of the pen, it didn't want to write. So that was something that was noticeable. But overall, I'm impressed so far. So let's see if these bled through the paper or not. Bum bum bum. All right. So definitely got some bleeding, as you can see here. But both the Copics that were on this side and the Mondos did. The Copics might have been worse. Like, look at that blue there. But it definitely bled through. Which, like I was saying, I don't think that this paper is too thick. So, but it only went through one piece of paper, which I thought it was gonna go through more. Like, this is the paper underneath it, and it's fine. So, bled through one. Let's see how bad it is on the back. Yeah, every single marker you can see. All right, that was the initial test. My initial reactions with these markers, I am impressed so far. I like them, and there's gonna be an issue because the thing that I drew is supposed to have a yellow in it, and this doesn't have a yellow in it, so I'm going to do my best. Cool. All right, I'm gonna get to drawing. Oh, I drew this big sketch of all of the characters in it, and now I'm going to color it in, so hit that time lapse and I'm gonna get to coloring. Alright, I'm gonna come on here and say that I'm starting to smell the alcohol in these alcohol markers after just getting this little segment done. It's very strong, so I just wanted to share that with you. I'm gonna keep on going, but whew, it's intense. was a majority of this painted. I think it took me about an hour to doodle all of this in. And I'm gonna let you know, I'm gonna cheat. I'm gonna cheat from this challenge because I don't have yellow. I'm going to use the yellow from the Copic markers to do this part. I'm gonna do that, and then there's gonna be some movie magic that's gonna go on here, and you're gonna see the finished product, alright? Cool. Alrighty, and kapow! Movie magic! So here it is, all colored in. We got all of our favorite little characters from Smiling Friends. I will say that I, for the most part, enjoyed using these markers. If you look in this blue section here, you can kind of see where I was able to make some darker sections. It was really hard to make lighter sections because, like, as soon as you overlapped two of the colors, like here's like a good example of it, it just took over. So it was really hard to keep it this lighter color to start off with. Same thing with the frog. I tried to do like lighter strokes, but this ink just spread so hardcore. Like without these black lines up here, there was no definition. These were just like purple blobs. You can see it, especially like if you can still see the pencil lines here in his hat. It just went so far beyond the lines that I had set. Like same thing here. Let me bring that up too. So you can see like in his eye, like I tried to get close, but it just like kept bleeding over. So that was one thing that was kind of like a pain. Like you can see it here in this yellow too, that the colors just kept bleeding over, or it took, I could only make this darker shade with it. For a little $25 kit of, you know, 40 different colored markers, I think it's a good value. Could I create stuff with this? Yeah, sure. Especially for like those daily challenges that I was doing. I think these markers would be a great tool just to have, just like a little variety so you're not, you know, having to mix colors or whatnot on the spot. Kind of gives you like a good variety. And I think like using these with like your Copic markers would be plenty fine if you just had like a primary set of Copic markers and then these on top of it, just to add some more variety of colors without spending, what was it, like $180 on a full set of Copic markers. So I think good job, Target. These, all of the nibs were really strong. Like I used the black like fine tip for all of the outlines here, and it didn't start to dull at all, so that was really nice that you could get like, so, you know, some thinner lines, or I didn't really do too many thick lines. Like I think this might be like the thickest line there, but you could like bring it to the side and make something thicker with it. So this is my rating for these markers. I think I'm gonna give them a 7 out of 10. They bled really bad. They smelled really bad too. For a moment there, I was like, I need to step outside and get some fresh air because these markers are strong. So that's why I'm going to give them a 7 out of 10 because they bled. They smell really strong and that it's hard to get like a light shade of these. Just for fun, how bad do you think that all of this bled through to the next paper? Because I'm very curious what the next sheet of paper looks like. So, ba ba ba. Alrighty. I'm just gonna go ahead and flip this over. So, next sheet of paper is pretty covered, but, oh. The third sheet of paper is not bad. So, like, if you were to put a piece of paper in between what you were drawing, I don't think you would have any issues, but it definitely did bleed through. Like, let me flip this over. Like, look, you have like a reverse image of what you drew on the back side of this paper because it just bled through so much. So Mondo Llama dual tip markers, 7 out of 10. Cool. Hi there, Editing Yaki here. I just wanted to let you know that I am now out of time to upload this video. It is Sunday night, so we're going to break this into two parts. This video is going to be a review of the alcohol markers. I went pretty in-depth with those and it took up a lot of time, so I hope it was helpful to you, and let me know if you go out and purchase them as well and tag me in any creations that you make at I'm the Yaki I'm the Yaki anywhere on the internet. And I will do a bonus video this coming week of the other half of the products that we are reviewing, which include acrylic paints from Mondo Llama. It also includes paint markers from Mondo Llama and canvases, $5 six pack canvases. And there's also some brushes as well that I used with the paints. So stay tuned for part two. I'm gonna try to get that edited tomorrow. So expect it up around Wednesday. And then we're also going to have a monthly update vlog on all the progress that I've been making so far this year. Talk about my struggles and then also the plan for February for what I'm gonna be working on and if you wanna work on as well. So thank you guys for being here. I appreciate you so much. Don't forget to hit the like and the subscribe button below. Stay tuned for the next one that should be up soon. If you hit the little bell, you'll get a reminder when that one comes up also. So stay beautiful. I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye. Okay, I'll just see ya. I'm just gonna go. See ya.